Translators and interpreters connect people from different cultures by converting one language into another.
When I have to do translations, I typically work in front of a computer, and I get different assignments from clients electronically. These are documents that are written in English, and I have to translate into the Spanish language.
Interpreting and translation are different professions. Interpreters deal with spoken words, while translators deal with written words. Monica Gelman does both.
When it comes to translators, you have a little bit more flexibility and a little bit less pressure because you have more time to consult dictionaries and to do a little bit more research. In the case of interpreters, everything's that pretty much right away.
Interpreters who work over the phone typically manage a 5-day, 40-hour week. But if you work out in the field assisting clients, you may average longer hours and be required to travel to the site where your services are needed.
Sometimes we have to travel to walk-in clinics or hospitals, and here we have the example of Steve Becerra. He's one of our expert interpreters that sometimes we send on the field. And we have Patsy, which is a patient with some third travel. So in this case, they are about to get into the walk-in clinic. The interpreter wants to get to know the patient a little bit better so they can meet and they can speak before getting into the clinic.
What kind of education is required to actually get into this field?
Well, typically, translators and interpreters need to have at least a bachelor's degree. And in the case of some translators and interpreters in specialized industries, they also need to have on-the-job certification.
More than 33% of translators and interpreters work in education, and 12% work in healthcare and social assistance. Another 10% work in areas of government. A growing number of foreign language speakers in the U.S. is expected to increase employment in this field.
Opportunities for seasoned translators and interpreters, statistics show that there will be a 24% increase in job for translators and interpreters.
All your hard work will pay off. Language specialists for the federal government earn on average more than $76,000 a year. Salaried interpreters and translators earn around $17 an hour.
What kind of person would really be good at this?
This is really good for a person that is very analytical, a person that also is knowledgeable about the various cultures involved. Also someone that, of course, is very educated.
If you enjoy helping people and communicating in different languages, interpreting or translating could be the career for you.
Ciao, Monica. Thank you.
Ciao. Bye. Thank you for coming.